looked pretty good on it, reading the body. I thought the shape of it would look pretty good if I could have. I just had a single axle for me right now, so I couldn't get a dual axle. If I could have got a dual axle and some good sound, I think it looked pretty good. Aha. Turn into the quarry. I think. Yeah, I don't remember, Russ. It's been a while since we've been over here. We're going to have to drive up Liverpool there, Rusty. I've been avoiding England, but I guess we do need to drive up to Liverpool and stop and visit Graham and his family up there, and Vicky and Shannon and all of his family up there in Liverpool. We need to make a run up that way. Yeah, we do, Doug. Trying to see how fast that is going down there. This big old monitor, it seems like just a long ways away here. Need to back the monitor up closer to me, I think. Easy now. I was coming in hot on the job here. Look there, my little buddies work on this one and everything. Don't know why I stopped there. Got a load ready to go out of here, bud?
Yeah, we got some rock ready to go out.
Some rock?
Yeah, you want to take it out of here.
Consider it gone.
Stand back up, buddy.
You talk funny.
That's all.
Why'd they call you Rusty? I think he called you Asshole Rusty. I don't think that's what he said, Ralph. I think he said A1 driver or something like that. All we got to do now is find your little truck and reset my track out, or it seems like I'm running sideways or something here. Let's see what kind of trucks we got out in here, people. It must be down in another hole. Now we're gonna have to pull her uphill a long ways, fella. Better hope the old Iveco keeps her cool. I miss this quarry. We've been over on ATS, and the quarries is harder to get in and out of over there, but they ain't got that big old climb to get you up out of them. Like this, and this will work you hard getting up out of it. Boy, that's a nice trailer there, Ralph.
Yeah, they're kind of short, Rusty.
I pushed the button for the gear shift, but I got for the splitter, but I got my steering wheel upside down, so of course I hit the button to light up the mirrors instead of the right button. See how she looks, folks. Oh, man. And I own that baby. Proud of that. Iveco man. I turned my turned my spotlights on if I know that. They've set me up a button for my other lights. Third gear. Let's see how that works out for us. Well, fourth not too good, better go back to third. This thing gonna be hard to back up with that little tiny trailer and three big axles on it. Guess I could let off throttle a little. Oh. First gear, that's all she got now, folks. We can't get her out of here with that and we're in trouble. In big trouble right here in River City. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Yeah, I seen that Iveco and I went in there looking for a Freightliner that I downloaded. And I seen that Iveco in there. With the shape of that cab, look like one of them old Garciers or whatever they was. And I said, I ought to get that thing. Well, I'm way up in fifth gear. Now you got her down there in Granny Low, Rusty. Yeah, I figured I'd put it down there and take it easy on the engine while we break it in there, Ralph. That hill is steep, people. You could spill your coffee on that hill. Or scare yourself to death, one. Kinda used to have to take them crane carriers up, except they're steeper than that. Old dozer just make you a real quick road and say, there you go, going up there. Whoops, I shouldn't have done that. That's a mess up. Tried to shift into second, I found out second had no power. Yeah, you found that out quick, didn't you, Rusty? Now, Doug, behave yourself. Told you, Doug. Now, if this thing quits, I should turn it off right now and let him come after you.
But you won't.
Am I?
No, you won't do that.
Picture down. Not a bad looking truck, I don't think. I think it's a good looking truck. I don't know about the brand, but now I think she's a good looking truck though. Or a goosey, I can't remember the name of that stupid truck. Freightliner thing, I think. What's another truck doing coming out in here? That looks like he's hauling them from fuel out for their equipment, Rusty. You know, they gotta have fuel to run that stuff. It don't run on your imagination. I know it, right? Yeah, one of these days we're gonna get us a load and we're gonna go right into Liverpool. And then we're gonna find Graham's house. Then we're gonna park right there in the yard and jump out and have dinner with the old boy. And talk to him about trucking. Since he's a trucker. Too good of birdies. Well, you blowing your horn, boy. I didn't bother you. Get in there. What you blowing your horn for? Everybody around here crazy. Let's get out of here, Doug.
Ah, let's go.
Seem like they all lost their mind.
That was loud, Santa Foxy.
About went one gear too many on that one, didn't I? Trying to figure out if I had a button configured to work my dash. Yeah, there we go. Can't see it very good, but got one. Have to zoom before I can see it. Come on, Iveco, let's go. Look at there, that big load. I should have got that. Now, watch out, Rusty. I don't know what these lights mean to flashing over here, I guess. Well, the red ones there, Ralph, means a train's coming, I think. Yeah, Mr. Obvious. Wonder which way it's coming. Right there it is. Choo-choo. I'm home, God, man. I'm gonna have to buy a horn for this thing. Can't have that. Listen to that. The car's got better horns. God, Ralph, remind me not to blow that in front of nobody. Now I'll try to remember there, Rusty. I like that dancing gal you got on the dashboard there. That'll keep me entertained the rest of the day. People, look there. Good morning, sunrise. Good morning, sunrise. Don't that look good? Coming up to greet you. Another day. On this big spaceship we call Earth. Boy, these people are driving like maniacs around here, Al.
Yeah, I seen that.
Well, you know, I was talking to Ralph.
What do you mean, what I always talk to Ralph? I would hang another train.
That's what happened when I always talked to Ralph.
Well, you, I don't know if you pay attention or not. You too broke to pay attention. I don't believe that, Mr. Duck. Terrible little sleeper back there where you at, Mr. Al.
Yeah, I know. Good thing he's got bunk beds back here, Rusty.
Well, you get the top, old buddy. Nah, that's all right with me. Losing a little horsepower right there on this little hill. I like that stuff up there, them cranes stuff. I miss that stuff over on ATS. They ain't got much of it sitting around moving as they have over here. I like moving them stacks of logs and stuff. I miss that stuff. That sunrise, sun right in my eyes. Yeah, it's bothering me way back here too, Rusty. Did you finally find them? Where was they? On your head. That's where stuff mostly is when you lose it. Right there on your face. If you hear a little vibration noise in the background, a little thumping, that's my G27 force feedback. I'm not over turning force feedback. It's always jarring and going on. I done a race a while ago on last night. 20 lap race on R Factor. And set the AI on 103%. And run them bellers, see what I could do with them. You'll have to wait till the video's up to find out. I downloaded that load just before we moved over to ATS. I downloaded that trailer there with the tow load on it. I think the name of it's a high load, a tow load or something like that. I downloaded that just before we moved over to the ATS. Oh, better get back inside. I'm fixing the wreck. Whoa, that scared me. Couldn't get it to turn around. My camera to turn. I tried to turn it around and look from the mirror, but I couldn't get it to turn. I'll give it a try, though. Iveco. If we don't get over, we ain't gonna have a split in half of Iveco. Have two of Iveco's. One for Ralph, one for me.
That's right, that's right.
We was out practicing racing today on a different track. We had a hell of a wreck, and old Ralph, he moaned and groaned, hollering and going on. I thought I killed him, but I don't think he's really hurt at all. I think he just thought he was hurt. Boy, look at those new lights. Bet that's some of Heavy Alex's work. MHApro map right here, version .1.26 for 1.26 ATS. He put those new overhead roll signs, and I'm sure he put those new lights on. Those are nice. You can get it at www and another W, MHApro.com. And you'll have a lot more stuff than you see. Now, don't forget to tell them about Premier Transport too, Rusty. While you're at it, you're always blabbing. Well, I'll do that, Phil. Yeah, I haul for Premier Transport, VTC. you fellas come over and join it, search it in Google or look in the link on my below this video, Premier Transport. You get a get you some telemetry software, and they automatic auto log except for the money, miles, and XP points in the picture you take at the end of the trip. And they don't require no number of trips a week or nothing like that. Drive when you want to drive. You get the Premier Transport scans. And once you get that telemetry software, you can go on that IP address on the top and get you a dashboard and a GPS to run off your iPad and your cell phone. And you'll be all set. So if you're interested, come over and join it. If not, forget everything I just said. I'm coming over, buddy. Where you gonna move or not? I'm coming over, car. That gone car. Nah, something people won't cut a break for you there, will they, Rusty? I think you're the biggest one of them all, right, Doug? That's all right with me. I like to be number one at something. Turn that on so we can see our speed there, 44 miles an hour. Watch out, little car, I wouldn't want to squeeze you. Them are nice little cars, Mini Coopers. Then a lot of racing games. People, I was thinking, I might have told it last time in the last video. On the set of course, Project Cars. And all those games, they got a little, look like an inch square box. In the center, that's got a picture of the steering wheel. And it's got three bar graphs that shows the gas, feed, the clutch, and the brake. I think that would be a great mod for one of the modders out there, if anybody's listening, to make for this game. Because that way the viewers could tell how far I was pushing the gas pedal, how I used the clutch, and how hard I pushed the brakes when I'm really, really scared, and how hard I pushed the brakes when I'm not scared. Last night I was driving and I run behind the truck and I couldn't hardly get stopped. And man, I got up to, I about shut my eyes. It was so much like real, I just about shut my eyes. I about pushed my gas pedals and stuff all the way out of here. I was on that brake with both feet, holding the clutch in on that brake, both feet, trying to get that thing stopped. And I could see the gnats on the back of that trailer when it stopped. It scared me. Yeah, it scared the hell out of me, Rusty. I thought we was a goner. I did too. We should have got out and looked. I bet you couldn't have slid a playing card between them. All I seen was the back of a truck when we stopped. But that's the fun part about it. It feels real. Sometimes it feels real. You get into it and you get trying to stop and you get scared. And next thing you know, if you ain't careful, you done pushed your brake pedals and stuff loose. I don't have that problem, though. Excuse me. I hooked mine. I got wood floors in this house. If anybody's wondering how to get their game, let's go through here just to look at it. How to get their pedals set up where they'll stay where they are without any trouble. I've got these, I bought a big roll of Velcro, and I put one on the floor and one, I put two long strips on the pedals and two long strips on the, this is nice through here. Two long strips on the pedal, two long strips on the floor, and just Velcro them to the floor, and they never move. I mean, that stuff will hold them. Coming out, folks, coming out. Just went detour through there. There's that long tall trailer. I went D through there and take a look at that. Detour through there and take a look at that rest area there. Pulling us down, people. We're gonna need, I didn't even look what horsepower that engine was. I think it was about 300 and something. It sure wasn't enough to get much done with. Sorry. They tell me you can gear a grasshopper right, and you can pull a train with it, so I don't guess it matters the size of the engine, it matters what gears in the gearbox. If you put the right gears in the gearbox, you can do anything you want to with any size engine. Just gotta have her geared right. I like them new signs, Mr. Alex. Goes across the highway here. Over the road. Only thing I forget about when I come back over here is these bridges that zooms off to one lane and you get yourself killed. You keep an eye on that today for me?
Yeah, I don't want to get hurt.
Well, we know you don't want to get hurt.
No, I don't want to get hurt.
Yeah, we've been hanging out a long time. Do you have a hard time saying that?
Yeah, right.
You're a pretty good old duck, even though you don't do anything.
Yeah, that's right.
Y'all don't know, viewers, what Duck and Ralph do. You think they just sit back there in that sleeper, but that's not the whole part of the story. Duck and Ralph is they unload these trucks when we go in there with a box trailer. We don't want to pay none of them fellas sitting around there to do it, so I kick back and drink soda pop, and I let Duck and Ralph do it. Yeah, that's right. You let us do it. You let us do it. I'm glad you let us do that, Rusty. Let's see what's happening here. Come on, buddy. Well, I'll be. Watch out, woman. Don't run on me. Watch these people. I've never seen them be. Everybody just stopped. Never happened like that in real life. Yeah, I let. Well, I don't let. But Ralph and the Duck, they do all the unloading and loading. Ralph runs the forklift, the Duck runs his mouth. And that's the way he goes. So they're not really as lazy as you think they are. They keep the fifth wheel greased. If I have a flat, they'd change the tires and all that kind of stuff. See what gear I got this bad baby in. Well, I don't know, that GPS there went crazy again right at the last minute, so I guess I have to jump inside and see. That GPS mod goes nuts on me every now and then. I like it the way it shows up and stuff, but the thing goes absolutely crazy on me. Kind of like the Doug. Yeah, Ralph. Don't want to scuff my Iveco. Iveco, whatever. Well, we got an easy parking place if we can just back this thing up. Straight. Should be able to do that. Alright, folks, we're gonna try this. Don't try this at home, okay? If you try it at home, do it better than I do. Come on, get around there now. I knew it. Now, how can you go wrong in a parking place that's that close? With a little short trailer. Probably ain't popping up because I ain't got my map up. There we go. Not a bad looking truck, if I must say so myself. Check that baby out.